guys, hope you're all well. I've been doing yet more sorting out from the house move. Oh my god, there just seems to be so many boxes, it's unbelievable. But we're really getting there now, we're getting straight, and hopefully I can do a room tour soon of my new room, which is exciting. Anyway, I've got another really old art journal share for you. I found this in a load of random boxes that were from the loft. So, and I have absolutely no idea how old this is because I haven't dated it. But yeah, so I thought I'd share anyway. They're not bound, they're loose leaf pages. I must have taken them out of the book with the intention of rebinding at some point. Oh, sorry, I'm doing this one-handed. So yeah, it's just loose leaf. Page is a loose leaf journal. There we go. But I thought I'd do a share anyway. And yeah, as I say, I don't know how old this is, so these could be really old. I don't really remember doing these. I think because I've been arting and art journaling for so long that you kind of forget what you've done when. Oh god, look at my hands. I've got ink all over my hands. Anyway, yeah, so I've been arting and art journaling for so long, you kind of, I think, lose track of what you've done and when you've done it. So, but I think one thing's for sure, you'll be able to really tell the difference between kind of what I do now and what I have done in the past. I think my style has changed loads and my ability has changed loads and that, yeah. So anyway, on with the flipperoonie. There we go. This is an old tea bag that I used and dried out and opened to. I saw once, I remember doing this page actually, because I saw once a technique with someone painting on tea paper, and I wondered if it would be, if a tea bag was the same, so that's what I did. And this is when I did faces without any expressions. If no, say that I still do faces like this a lot, to be honest with you. If I can't be bothered to, either can't be bothered to do an expression or don't feel like they need an expression, if that makes sense. Yeah, so anyway, I do still do faces like that, so that was a bit of a lie, but anyway, there you go. A journal page all about my love of tea. It says, I do love my cup of tea. It reassures me and makes me feel all warm and snuggly. To me, a cup of tea is like being home and means that everything is going to be okay. There we go. And I have a feeling the rest of that was just done with Pro Marker and paint. This background, I think, is paint, and there's some corrugated card here. It's more glittery. That's glittery, I think, that cupcake. Yeah, don't know if the camera's really picking that up, but yeah, in cupcakes we trust. I still really love this page. I really, really love this page. I was just looking at it before I did the flip through. Now, if I can remember rightly, or I think by looking at it, the background is paint that I've used a sponge, I think, because looking at it, it's got like a spongy sort of texture, and I've kind of mottled it. And this, I still have this stamp, and I think that's with white paint, and this looks like there's some alcohol ink along here too. But yeah, I still really like this page. I think it's pretty. So yeah, I might try and recreate this at some point, because in like, you know, I've advanced some, because I do really, really like this page. This, I definitely know background was alcohol inks, because I could just tell straight away, and I think I used them straight onto the page without using alcohol inks, because they look like they've just, the blobs look like they've literally just been absorbed into the paper. So no writing, so obviously just having a creative time. Yeah, you can see the inks come through the back, front, back. I think this may have been some of my early advance or my early experiments with face drawing. And for an early one, I'm actually quite impressed, really. For an early one, I think that's not too bad. Daydream Believer. I love this page. I still love this page with my attempt at animal print there. Show it that way around. So I've got a little face peeking out of the side. And it says, run wild, run free, let your creative beast out, grrr, wild child. I don't know, must have been in a funky mood. So looking at it, I think this is ProMark, and I think that's paint. Yeah, look, it bleeds through. This is another alcohol ink background with just some black pen doodling. So it says, grow, reach up high, aspire. I like this page. It's a happy page. Happy, happy page. Ooh, the inky goodness. Just trying to, I haven't actually read some of these. I don't know if they're really cringy. I've just kind of casually looked at that. I think that might be a bit cringy. What does it say? Okay, it's not too bad. I love my husband with all my heart, and I can't imagine life without him. Childhood sweethearts we met at school and have had 15 happy years together. My life, my love, my soulmate. Oh, okay, now, this has got me thinking. This page is not that old. This page is only a year and a half old. But these previous ones are older than that. A lot older than that. So I think this must have got just jumbled up with all the others. But hey, oh well. Never mind. Gosh, what's this one? Shall I read it? Hang on. Yeah, not too cringy. I'm an overthinker, it's true. I do overthink and I overanalyze too. I see myself in different ways depending on what I am thinking at the time. I need to learn to be easier on myself. I am, after all, just a person too. I mainly see myself as a free spirit, not wanting to be tied down to anything. Yeah, that's still true. Still true even now. And look at the background. That looks like some of my early experimentations in mark making. So some bubble wrap and some sort of line thing. And a fingerprint butterfly. How cute. How cute. So yeah, I wish I'd dated these. There you go, everybody. Mental note. Date your pages. Another faceless girl, which I actually really, really like. I like her. Oh, see, look, I've ripped it out of the book, so no intention of ever putting it back in the book. What have we got here? Feelings are much like waves. We can't stop them from coming, but we can choose which one to surf. That's pretty true, I believe. And I just think this is a mixture of painting techniques. Let's see if I can give you a cut. Just various different paint markings. Yeah, I think that's an alcohol ink background, that's darker, so that must be the good side, and that's the back side, but I obviously thought the paler side was the better side. And I think this is a girl out of Pro Markers that I've just stuck down there. I quite like her. I think she's quite sweet. And she's a bit squishy looking. She's a bit not very geometric, but same background, same Pro Marker combo. Let's just paint. This thing, I just, without being dated, I don't know where I was at in my life, and I don't kind of like, and there's no words as well, so It's kind of, I'm not sure whether it was just a period where I've just thought, hey, let's just paint something or let's just be creative. Because this is on different paper again. So I get the feeling that this is just not even, I think this is over various time frame because it's different paper. It's just totally different paper. So it's not even out of the same, same book. I mean, that one's, and it just, it's just got a different quality. The paper just a different quality. So I think we're looking at a massive jumble of eras and timescales here, I quite like this painting. I wish I'd put a date on it. I don't know how old it was, but there we go. This is a magazine picture of a Buddha statue that I've just kind of painted the background and then kind of just dry brushed over it to kind of make it blend. And I obviously that was where my inspiration stopped, but maybe I'll do something with that. That's quite cool. I got given a load of scrapbook stuff. I remember this, but I can't remember when. Gosh, but I remember being given it. And so that's why I kind of used up some of the random letters. And there's some like leaves there as well. And some scrapbook paper. And this isn't sort of like my usual style, as you can see. My usual style is sketching or painting. So a little bit of experimentation there. And I think there's a few of those pages in the pile still. What was I saying? For me, autumn is all about the snuggles. The walks in the woods, hot chocolate, soups, scarves, pumpkin pie, conker fights, rustling leaves and watching films. You know, I'm filming this on one of the hottest days we've had so far. It's July 2013, and just thinking about snuggling with a film and a hot chocolate on a autumn day after a nice walk in the woods just actually feels quite nice right now. Oh my word, next one's Christmas! How cool! So I've got some scrapbook paper and some rub-ons and this is a badly printed out photo of me and my husband. I've just done on some sort of random bit of paper there. And also that's some book text, some more rub-ons. Christmas, the one time you can act like a crazy kid and no one stops you. Oh, how true. I love Christmas. Do you know what? Saying that, I love autumn too and I love winter, but I actually like every season because I think every season has got something different in it. They all have their own merits. Oh, that's peeling. They all have their own merits. I'm quite looking forward to Christmas though, especially as we're in a new house and our new house has got a fireplace. Oh, look at the back of that page. That was the autumn page. I love the back of that. This one's scrapbook paper, so I must have a back. Oh, just fairly stripy. This one kind of looks unfinished because I've still got all the pencil marks in it. It looks like some watercolour maybe in the background there. It's not alcohol ink. So it must be, I think it looks like watercolour. What have I written? The road you take is the fun part. So, there we go. Quite pretty, I think. So yeah, that's back to that other paper again. Oh, little bit of a collage-y expedition there. So this background is made from paint chip samples from Dulux, which I obviously stole. I think this was from when back in our old house. Quite a few years ago now. It was Magnolia, the bathroom, and we repainted it blue. So I must have scabbed these paint samples when we were doing that. So there's some modelling paste there, and a little button and a sticker. What have I done? I've sort of kind of collaged some scrapbook paper and some other paper there. As we say, sometimes in life you can feel really blue, but you just got to pick yourself up and get on with it. Oh dear, must have been having a blue day. But you know, that's kind of, for me, a lot of that's what art journaling is about. That if you are having a blue day, which obviously clearly was, you can just kind of get lost in this, in your art, and art is therapy. So, yes. Oh, some more collagey page. Another collagey page. Because I've got book text and scrapbook paper, and that's a Tim Holtz tag. So I think that could possibly... don't know. When did Tim Holtz start doing these tags? I know I've had them for yonks. So I've got smile, laugh, enjoy, inspire, create daily, live an inspired life. There we go. And some buttons. So obviously, as I say, like, I'm normally a painter or a sketcher or a... I do use papers in my own bits, but actually... yeah, I was about to say it's not really very much my style, but here it looks like I obviously had a go. And now, thinking on it, I use collage elements and other things like buttons far more than I ever used to, but I do incorporate them with my own sketches and stuff. So I think this is probably kind of a what do they call it? I've lost for words, I've been rambling too much. A transition phase into a different style of art journaling, I think. This is another collagey one. Paintings, scrapbook papers and embellishments, and so say, sweethearts, the greatest first love, my husband, Aaron John, established 1997. So was this a page I did in 97? Probably not. But that's really sweet. How cute. Yeah, I met my husband at school, in senior school, in our GCSE year. We were put together. I mean, I'd known him for years, but we'd never really paid each other much attention, to be honest. And then we both ended up doing geography, and none of our friends did, and we just kind of ended up being put sat next to each other, and that was that. And this is the last page. I transition into more sketching, so it's kind of, that's more my style. Now, that's an early one though. Oh, it's a naked fairy in the background. I've still got this paint. I still have this paint. I love this paint so much. It's all sparkly. It's pink and sparkly. I'm wandering off into the weird now. What did it say? Someone once told me that if you drew a fairy, magical things would happen. There we go. I love this page. I love looking back sometimes on my old stuff, and some of it I look at and I cringe, and other stuff I'm like, oh, I love that. And this is one of them. I just like looking at the pretty fairy and the glitteriness. Anyway, I'm rambling. Probably a really, really uber long video. But there we go. Like a bit of a random years, random style, transition-y art journal. So, thanks for watching. Bye.